Now on KGW News, clarity. Everyone in Oregon can now find out exactly when they'll be eligible for the vaccine.
Nothing could be soon enough, of course.
But getting an appointment is still a struggle. Back to the movies. Local theaters reopen as COVID risk levels fall. Then, another frightening night for some Portlanders. Three shootings leave two people dead and bullet holes in a child's bedroom.
We begin tonight at 11 with a moment high school football players have been waiting for all year. They're finally allowed to play again. Thank you for joining us. I'm Laurel Porter. But the Friday night atmosphere is drastically different. Mike Benner takes us to one of the first games of this strange season.
The wait is over. The Camas Papermakers are back on the football field to kick off their 2020 season that was delayed by the pandemic. Junior kicker Matthew Girardo recalls the day he found out there would be football.
It was good news once we got into switching the gear and kind of started our season up.
Make no mistake about it, though. This season will look nothing like the ones before it.
In the very beginning, the coaches, all lined us up and talked to us, and they said, if you want to play football this year, this is just what you have to do.
At the top of that to-do list is masks. Everyone has to wear a face covering, even players on the playing field. We're told teams will not use locker rooms. Instead, they'll meet in end zones or in the stands. And players will be asked to socially distance on the sidelines. That'll be a tough one, according to Camas Athletic Director Rory Oster.
And that's a hard ask of kids to stay spaced out. I'm really afraid I'll probably have to take some policing and do some work by myself on the sideline because, high school boys are herd animals. So they go where the pack goes.
All of that said, Oster believes the biggest adjustment is fans. None will be allowed at the Camas game, but that may look different at different schools. As it stands right now, state guidelines allow for 200 people max at these games. That includes players, coaches, cheerleaders, and game personnel, among others. It'll be up to individual schools to determine if some fans can fit under the 200-person limit. And if so, they'll have to decide which fans will be the lucky ones.
Everyone's been working hard to put in place protocols that will abide by the guidelines and make sure that kids are safe.
At the end of the day, that's what it's all about. Players like Matthew Girardo understand that and appreciate it.
Camas football here is just big. And that's the buzz on Friday nights is the football game. So just, try to be flexible and try to do the best you can to just go with the flow, because the sooner we get this over with, the sooner we can get back to normal football.
It's clear that 200-person cap at games is the biggest bummer for people. Washington State Governor Jay Inslee was asked as recently as Thursday if that number could increase. He says he's looking into this and hoping to make some progress. In the meantime, you should check with your favorite school and team to see if they'll be streaming the game, because that is the plan for Camas High. I'm Mike Benner for KGW News.
And we will have highlights from the Camas game coming up in sports. There is big news on the vaccine rollout tonight. The state of Oregon laid out a clear timeline for when everyone will be eligible for the vaccine. Eligible is the key word here, however, because demand, at least at this point, is still way higher than the supply of doses coming into the state. Pat Doris has our update.
For the past 3 weeks, we've seen our case counts steadily decline. Our hospitalizations have matched that. And last week, we reported the lowest COVID-19 deaths since the summer.
And the positive percentage for COVID tests is hovering around 3%, another good sign. With that in the background, the governor announced she would move forward, making 65-year-olds eligible for COVID shots this coming Monday. Her other big announcement, we know now the latest date everybody else in the state will be eligible for a vaccine. March 29th, those who are 45 and above and have underlying medical conditions will be eligible for COVID vaccinations. Those conditions are defined by the CDC and include cancer, type 2 diabetes, and obesity. Notably, the list does not include smokers. Certain others, like farm workers, food processing workers, and people experiencing homelessness, will also be eligible March 29th. The next group becomes eligible May 1st and includes those who are 16 and older with underlying medical conditions, along with grocery and restaurant workers, also bar staff, and those who work in retail, construction, and government jobs that cannot work from home. June 1st, anyone who is 45 and older can get the shots. And July 1st, anyone 16 and older qualifies.
Of all seniors,
Oregon Health Director Patrick Allen said if Oregon gets the vaccine shipments he expects, we'll see many more vaccine appointments available by mid-March.
If Oregon's prime dose allocation increases to approximately 200,000 doses per week, Oregon would have enough first doses to vaccinate 7 in 10 adults by the end of April 2021 and all adults by the end of May 2021.
But Allen said until then, it will be rough for seniors trying to get appointments. And neither the governor nor Allen would support a pause, which would push back the eligibility date for 65-year-olds until more seniors get their shots.
And while we've got this scheduling challenge that we're working to fix, it just seems really difficult to go back yet again to those same seniors and say, and it turns out that date's not going to work either, and we'll get back to you.
There's another big change today for how you sign up for a vaccine appointment if you're trying to go to the Oregon Convention Center site. Instead of trying to fight for an appointment all at once, you can now sign up to have health officials contact you when an appointment is available. This is the new website you'll need to go to. It's getvaccinated.oregon.gov. It will ask you several eligibility questions. Then, if you're eligible, you'll have a chance to enter your contact information. Your name will be put into a queue at that point. Then you'll be contacted when a dose is available for you. This is only for people in Multnomah, Washington, and Clackamas counties who are trying to sign up for the convention center site. If you have mobility issues and you're trying to go to the Portland Airport site, you'll still use the old sign-up portal. It also does not apply if you're trying to get a shot through a pharmacy. You still need to go through the pharmacy website in that case. New risk levels went into effect today in Oregon as 16 counties see lower case numbers. This map shows the new levels. Today's changes include Clackamas and Washington counties, which go from high to moderate risk. Marion and Yamhill counties move from extreme to high risk. Multnomah County stays at high risk. Those changes impact restaurants struggling to stay open. Starting today in Washington and Clackamas counties, businesses can let more customers inside. We went to Oregon City today to talk to restaurants about the boost. Now restaurants in moderate risk counties can offer indoor dining at 50% capacity. The owner of the Verdict Bar and Grill told us the change came just in time, but he says he's been down this road before.
We're just cautious. They've been yo-yoing us back and forth, so we're just, we're happy. We're happy to be open. We got our fingers crossed that we're going to be able to stay open.
We also talked to the owner of Mesa Fresca across the street. He said at one point during the pandemic, he was down to 2 employees. Himself and one other. Now he's up to 16 employees. Lower risk levels also mean indoor entertainment can increase capacity. Many movie theaters decided to reopen this weekend, including the Century Eastport Plaza in Southeast Portland.
It feels good. This is one of our hobbies that we go to the movies every week. It hasn't been over a year now since we've been to one, but yeah, it's exciting.
Very excited. This is a thing that we like to do every weekend, so it's been good to have it back. Got the popcorn, got the Diet Coke, just like the commercial.
The governor made a late decision yesterday to allow theaters to start selling those concessions as well. Cinemark, which runs this theater, is staggering showtimes and seating to allow for social distancing. They're also disinfecting theaters between each showing. We saw another round of gun violence in Portland overnight. There were 3 different shootings. In the first, just before 9 o'clock last night, 3 people were shot. One was killed near Northeast 66th and Halsey. Then, just before 11 last night, a man was shot and killed in North Portland near Farragut Park. We don't know yet what led up to those shootings. In the third, no one was hurt, but several bullets were fired into a house and one of them hit a bed that a 12-year-old boy was sleeping in. Portland police shared these photos and you can see a bullet hole in the mattress. This happened just after 3 this morning on Southeast 66th Avenue. 3 other people were inside the home, including a 13-year-old. We also learned today a Portland police criminalist is accused of driving drunk to one of those shooting scenes. Bradley McIntyre was on duty and was called to investigate the Northeast 66 shooting. A supervisor noticed concerning behavior from McIntyre and told him to wait in the passenger seat of his car. That's when they say he drove off. A patrol officer pulled him over and he was arrested for DUII. He is now on paid leave and is set to appear in court.